If you are from the Midwest, you have most likely had some experience with road salt. It is put on our roads and highways to melt snow and ice every winter so we can safely get to where we need to go. Wisconsin is one of six states that together use 3/4 of the total road salt used in northeastern and midwestern states. The Wisconsin Department of Transportation uses an average of 385,000 tons of salt every year. That's enough to fill more than one snowplow per person in the city of Eau Claire. This number doesn't even account for salt used by companies, schools, other privately owned organizations, and the general public.
So the question is, where does all that road salt go after it's put on the road? Much of it ends up in rivers, such as the Chippewa River. Road salt dissolves in melted snow and is washed down storm drains and comes out storm pipes like this one, directly into the river. Road salt does not go to the wastewater treatment plant and is not removed from the water before going into the Chippewa River. Road salt can have harmful effects on plants and animals that depend on the river. The Lower Chippewa River supports a wide variety of flora and fauna, which are all threatened by changes in their ecosystems. Road salt is made of two elements, sodium and chloride. Concentrations greater than 250 milligrams of chloride per liter of water can be toxic to most freshwater life. It's been recorded by the Wisconsin Department of Natural Resources Bureau of Watershed Management that chloride levels in rivers in southeastern Wisconsin, especially around the urban Milwaukee area, have reached 230 milligrams per liter, which is the chronic water quality level established by the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency. Some rivers have been recorded at much higher levels during the early spring months.
Fortunately, this isn't true for the Chippewa River yet. This graph was provided to us by the Wisconsin DNR. Chloride concentrations in the Chippewa River are measured sporadically near Chippewa Falls. This graph shows the results of these tests beginning in 1961 and ending in 2009. The concentration hasn't reached a dangerous level yet, but it has been steadily rising and will continue to rise if our current habits are not changed.
So what can we do to preserve the health of the Chippewa River? One way is to put pressure on the local and state government to reduce the amount of road salt used every year. Contact the city council officials in charge of public works.
There are also other substitutes and additives that the city could use, like calcium magnesium acetate, which isn't as harmful as road salt, or sugar byproducts, which lower the melting temperature of ice. These may be more expensive, but the environmental benefits are worth it. You can also help by reducing your own personal use of road salt. If you use road salt at your home or local business, mix the salt with additives like sand or gravel. By using less road salt, we can help preserve our Chippewa River for future generations.